Hi, I'm Parul. And
Hi, Parul.
Just to take off from what she said, I want to know what you think about Sanskrit, because when I was studying it in school, everybody said you're studying a dead language and that you should learn maybe a Spanish or a French, but Sanskrit is a dead language. But from what you're saying, it sounds like people should study it so that they can read it in their...
The way
it's taught today is disastrous. Those tables through which we are taught, you know, which we have to mug up, those tables were made by Bhandarkar ji, right? And from what I am aware, those tables were made to help in the creation of the critical edition of the Mahabharata. So it was made for a different purpose. It is not an ideal tool to teach. Like, we don't learn English by mugging up tables, right? Or Hindi by mugging up tables. That's not the way to learn a language. You should read plays. You should read literature of that language. You should speak in that language. That's the way to learn a language. And Sanskrit is a key to open the wisdom of our ancestors. There was a wonderful opportunity we had, when we got independence, a motion that was moved and supported, by the way, by Dr. Ambedkar. Sadly, we did not listen to him at that time. It was Dr. Ambedkar and many South Indian MPs who were pushing for Sanskrit to become our national language. Sadly, it was voted down. You should read the Constituent Assembly debates to understand why. One of the more disastrous decisions our founding fathers made. I hope it's not too late now, but there's, we can't give up on that language. It's a key. But the least we can do is at least start translating our texts. Try and encourage this language, at least get scholars into it. You'll be shocked to know that many of the, historians who have written the seminal texts of our history books, which are taught in our schools, don't even know a word of Sanskrit. It's as ridiculous as someone writing the seminal book of French history, not knowing a word of French. How bizarre is that? Yeah. But we as a country have accepted this for 70 years, this state of affairs. How do we open the knowledge of our... There are so many manuscripts, so much to be read, so much to be understood. And I'm saying again, they're not all spiritual texts. Many of them are science, mathematics, physics, metallurgy. It's a huge amount of information and knowledge our ancestors have left. So much was destroyed. Nalanda University, when it was burned down. I've said this repeatedly, perhaps the biggest disaster for humanity was when Nalanda University was destroyed. God knows how much knowledge was lost. Many other universities were destroyed. Takshashila, Ujjain, Mahodayapuram in the south, in Kerala. But we still have managed to save a lot. But we are not studying it. That's our fault. We can't keep blaming the British and the Turks forever. And we've been free for 70 years. It's our fault, frankly.